सो नाउ वी विल गो स्टूडेंट्स फॉर आवर वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग. सो देयर आर सम प्रॉब्लम्स अकर्ड एंड दिस वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग टेक्निक इज़ एक्चुअली फॉलोड फ्रॉम एंशियंट टाइम. इट्स नॉट अ न्यू टेक्निक. नाउ वी आर मोर गिविंग मोर फोकस ऑन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट. हाउ कैन वी हार्वेस्ट वाटर, हाउ कैन वी स्टोर वाटर, हाउ कैन वी सेव वाटर. बट एक्चुअली दिस टेक्निक इज़ एंशियंट टेक्निक एंड बिफोर ब्रिटिश अराइवल आर एंसेस्टर हैव ऑल्सो फॉलोड. लोकल पीपल हैड फोकस्ड मोर ऑन इट एंड रियली पीपल वेर गेटिंग बेनिफिट फ्रॉम इट. सो इट्स नॉट क्वाइट अ न्यू टेक्निक. जस्ट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिमोलिश इट एंड ट्राइंग टू यूज़ इट अगेन. सो वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट और वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग टेक्निक और वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट इज़ क्वाइट ओल्ड फॉर अस एंड वी हैव गॉन फॉर इट. सो वी विल टॉक अप नाउ अबाउट वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग. हाउ वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग कैन बी फॉलोड एंड हाउ इट इज़ फ्रूटफुल फॉर ऑल द पीपल हु आर लिविंग हियर बाय एंड फॉर एवरी पीपल. सो वॉट इज़ मीन बाय वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट? वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट एम्फासाइजेस साइंटिफिक सॉइल एंड वाटर कंजर्वेशन इन ऑर्डर टू इंक्रीज द बायोमास प्रोडक्शन. द एम इज़ टू डेवलप प्राइमरी रिसोर्सेस ऑफ लैंड एंड वाटर टू प्रोड्यूस सेकेंडरी रिसोर्सेस ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स फॉर यूज़ इन अ मैनर विच विल नॉट कॉज इकोलॉजिकल इम्बैलेंस. सो वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट नॉट ओनली इंक्रीजेस द प्रोडक्शन एंड इनकम ऑफ द वाटरशेड कम्युनिटी बट ऑल्सो मिटिगेट्स ड्रॉट्स एंड फ्लड्स एंड इंक्रीजेस द लाइफ ऑफ द डाउन स्ट्रीम डैम एंड रिजर्वायर वेरियस डाउन स्ट्रीम डैम्स एंड द रिजर्वायर्स. मीन्स द पीपल हु आर क्लोज टू द डैम विल नॉट ओनली गेट अ प्रॉपर बेनिफिट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इनकम बट ऑल्सो इट कैन फुलफिल द डिमांड ऑफ द पीपल हु आर लिविंग फार फ्रॉम द डैम. ओके, मीन्स दिस पीपल मे नॉट सफर फ्रॉम एनी काइंड ऑफ ड्रॉट्स ऑल्सो, कैन नॉट सफर फ्रॉम एनी काइंड ऑफ फ्लड ऑल्सो एंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मनी ऑल्सो. मीन्स ऑल काइंड ऑफ क्रॉप्स कैन बी गेटिंग टू द पीपल हु आर लिविंग फार. सो दिस इज़ रियली वेरी फ्रूटफुल मैनेजमेंट दैट इज़ कॉल्ड एज अ वाटरशेड मैनेजमेंट. सो वेरियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैव बीन वर्किंग ऑन रीजनरेटिंग एंशियंट सिस्टम्स ऑफ वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग इन एन अल्टरनेटिव टू द मेगा प्रोजेक्ट्स. राइट, डैम इज न्यूली इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बट सिंस आर इन एंशियंट इंडिया दिस टेक्निक्स आर फॉलोड बाय द लोकल पीपल. वॉट आर दोज टेक्निक्स वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट? दिस कम्युनिटीज हैव यूज हंड्रेड्स ऑफ इंडिजीनियस वाटर सेविंग मेथड्स टू कैप्चर एवरी ट्रिकल ऑफ वाटर दैट हैड फॉलोन ऑन दर लैंड. डग स्मॉल पिट्स एंड लेक्स, पुट इन अ प्लेस सिंपल वाटरशेड सिस्टम्स, बिल्ट अ स्मॉल अर्दन डैम्स. स्मॉल अर्दन डैम इज द वेल नोन कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर द पीपल ऑफ द विलेजेस. Village in village small earthen dams every year practice there every year this practice is following. Then constructed dikes, sand and limestone reservoirs, this is also done. Students, you might not be knowing, but whenever I was small I have seen such kind of things, small pits on a rock, and that water can be means people can get benefit from that small pits and from small ponds. People were using that water for washing clothes, for cleaning their utensils and all. We have seen when I was small. Setup of rooftop water collecting units, means the water which is accumulating on the roof, that water is collecting and storing into the small containers. So this practice is also followed since ancient time. It is also not quite new. This has recharged groundwater levels. At the same time, it can recharge also underground water table. It can increase the seepage of the water. It can moisturize the water. And at the same time, that water can go river back to the that water can go into the river in the form of, and in this manner that river water we can get a benefit through small small channel. That water which is underground can go into the river, and that water can get means people can get benefit from that water. So water harvesting in an old age concept in India, it's very important that water harvesting technique is not new, it's old age concept in India. So in what form the water is stored? Water harvesting is an old age concept in India. Khadins, tanks and nadis in Rajasthan. See students, it's really very important to keep in mind. You have to keep in mind and you have to listen it very properly. Baga, khadins, tanks and nadis, these are the water harvesting structures. In which state, in which area? Rajasthan. So question may ask you, in Rajasthan, how the watershed management was done in olden India. So water was stored in Rajasthan in the form of khadins, tanks and nadis. So in this manner all you have to keep in mind. And then next is in Maharashtra, bandaras and tals, tala jala apan mhanto, bandaras and tals. Okay, so such things are there. We will see here now how it is done. Water harvesting means capturing water, capture, collection and storage of rainwater and surface runoff in a local area for filling either small water bodies or recharging groundwater, so that water continues to be available in non-rainy season, and that is called as a water harvesting. So keep in mind the proper definition of the water harvesting. So once again I would like to repeat for you student, water harvesting means capturing water, capture, collection and storage of rainwater and surface runoff in a local area for filling either small water bodies or recharging groundwater, so that water continues to be available in non-rainy season, is known as water harvesting. It is an old, age-old practice in India. It is the region-specific technique and is beneficial for local people. This deals with recharging of groundwater. Because of the water harvesting, we can recharge underground water level. Okay. Ensuring the water availability in non-rainy season, reducing chances of floods during rainy season. All the water can be collected under the ground, right? To seep the one drop of water, it takes 72 hours. So if we have a technique proper for the seepage, for absorbing the water into the soil, then we can do this process faster. And that water we can use it whenever there is no rain. Availability of the water for drinking and irrigation throughout the year. This is also one of the important motto of rainwater harvesting. Means the people must get water for drinking purpose as well as for the irrigation purpose to throughout year. So some of the ancient water harvesting techniques or structures are followed into the various states of India. That is khadins, tanks and nadis in Rajasthan, bandaras and tals in Maharashtra, bandis in Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Means whatever the water containers were there, those water containers are called bandis in Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. In Bihar, that is called as a ahars and pines. In Himachal Pradesh, it is called as a kuls. In Tamil Nadu, it is called eris, means tanks only. In Kerala, it is called as a surangams. So students, you might have seen the wells of the Kerala. You are knowing wells of the Maharashtra, right? Small narrow wells are there, right? But in Kerala, there are the wells, means rectangular shaped their wells are there, and that rectangular shape everywhere there are small small stairs, so from all sides people can get down and can bring the water. So that is called as surangams in Kerala. Karnataka, the water storage containers are called as a kattas. And Kandi belt of Jammu region, in Jammu Kashmir, whatever the water harvesting structures are called, that is called as a ponds. So giving people control over their local water resources ensures that mismanagement and over exploitation of these resources is reduced and removed. Understood, students? Once it is goes to the government, the over exploitation of the water can take place, as well as the unequal distribution of water can be taken place. But such practices, that is malpractice, such malpractices can be stopped if this right is given to the local people. This mismanagement cannot be taken place by the local people, because local people are giving benefit for each and every person of the village. So mega projects have a number of drawbacks, and various organizations, both central and state agencies, have embarked upon regenerating ancient systems of water harvesting as an alternative to the mega projects like dams. These communities have used hundreds of indigenous water saving methods to capture every drop of rainwater. Small pits, ponds, lakes, watershed systems, other dams, dikes, sands, and limestone reservoirs, rooftop collecting systems, etc. This has recharged groundwater levels and even brought rivers back to life. Hydrologists added a few modern methods and improved the ancient ones. Watershed management, growing more trees in watershed area, increases the retention of rainwater and protection of soil from erosion. Therefore, watershed management emphasizes soil and water conservation scientifically in order to increase the biomass production. Biomass production means what kind of production, students? Can you guess? Biomass means the increased variety of plants and animals. So because of the availability of the water, the plants and animals can grow very abundantly and very richly. So our area can be rich in flora and fauna, can be rich in various kinds of varieties of plants and animals will be available, and in that manner we can increase the biomass, and everywhere there will be green revolution and people can live happily. So this term is related. So students, so wherever there is a scarcity of water, there is a poverty, and wherever there is a availability of the more water, means there is an abundance of water, there is the prosperity. So we can correlate this. Wherever there is a poverty, there is less water, and where there is a prosperity, there is a abundant water, because people can get all type of means people are getting benefit, people are being really very happy, people are being prosperous if there is a water. So water is actually the sign of the prosperity, students. You might have seen somewhere abundancy is shown by the water, means prosperity, symbol of the prosperity is the water. So what is the aim of watershed management? To develop the primary resources of land and water, to produce secondary resources of plants and animals which will not cause ecological imbalance. Water is only the resource which can maintain the environmental balance, ecological balance, which can maintain the food chain and the food web. So water is really a great source and a great gift given by the nature, and so that only, students, we have to use this really very judiciously. From today onwards, you decide to maintain or to use usage of water very properly. So we should not allow the runoff water to run only. We have to close the water taps then clear your leaky water tap, right? Repair your leaky water tap. That is really very essential. So it relates to our prosperity. So really, really, it's really very, I'm very happy to say you that prosperity is always shown by the water. So keep really very safe. If you'll keep safely water, if you'll use safely water, your prosperity will increase. Then significance of the watershed management. It mitigates droughts and floods. It checks floods and droughts. It does not cause any kind of floods and does not cause any kind of droughts if there is a proper watershed management would be there. It increases the life of the downstream dams and reservoirs. It's really very important, students. The people who are far can get a proper benefit from the watershed management. So it increases the life of the downstream dams and the reservoirs too. Okay, so here now, students, I'm going to explain you one concept, that is of khadin. See, in this picture you can see khadin. What is khadin? Khadin means actually a largely level terrain, which is in the Rajasthan. I said you, it's a largely level terrain. The water harvesting structures are mainly crescent shaped earthen embankment. See here, students, you can see here in this picture a crescent shaped earthen embankment. Crescent shaped earthen embankment, that is called khadin, or low straight concrete and rubble check dams built across the dam. Okay, there is one small khadin or bund is drawn. Okay, that bund and that khadin is actually working like a dam only. The rainwater from catchment area, students, you can see here, the rainwater which is coming from the catchment area flows down and the slopes and stopped by the bund and forms a reservoir. Here this water is collected, and that excess water, see, the water which is collected, that water can be utilized for drinking purpose also and for irrigation purpose also. But the water which is seeping down, which is getting absorbed by the soil, which is getting absorbed by the surface soil area, that water will get more seepage and it will increase the underground water table. So we are getting benefit both the ways, means we can use it either for drinking, either for irrigation, or underground water table is also going to be increased. So it's really very essential, students. So the excess water flows across the bund and goes into the shallow wells dug behind the bund. Behind the bund there is a shallow wells. Okay, so that is also fruitful. That shallow bunds, it will accumulate into that, and so monsoon rainfall the ponds behind the structure. You can see, students, here is the diagram. Shallow dug well. In that, what will happen? That fresh water will gather, okay, and fill the ponds behind the structures. Only the large structure hold water year round. For a year, that water can be collected. Most of them dry up 6 months. After 6 months, it is getting dry, or less after the monsoon. Sometimes it is drying up. If there is a large amount of it, then water can be dry up because of evaporation. And sometimes it can less after the monsoon. Their main purpose is, however, not to hold the surface water, but to recharge the groundwater. Okay, it's the main motto is what? However the water is present, wherever the water is present, that water can be utilized for drinking, for irrigation. And if it is seeping down, then also it is going to be fruitful, because that water we are going to utilize for what? To increase the underground water table. So this traditional water harvesting technique is followed into the Rajasthan, that is called as a khadin, and really it is very essential, because once that water flows and go into the sea, then that water is going to become saline, and then it is no more, it is of no more use of us. So that water, we have to keep it safely before going into the sea water. So saline water we cannot utilize, but the water we can have a proper management for drinking, for irrigation, and for the proper seepage, means to increase the underground water table. So this is related to the khadins. Now we will talk about advantages of the groundwater. What are the advantages of the groundwater? It doesn't evaporate. Actually, whenever I started the water, that time only I explain you, it does not evaporate as it is under the ground, because the evaporation is the surface phenomenon. Only surface water can be evaporated, and that water is under the ground, so no heat of the sun can reach over there for the evaporation. So this water, we can save it, so it doesn't evaporate. Then it spreads out to recharge wells. There are various channels, and through that channels it can give a recharge of water throughout the year. Then it provides water for irrigating vegetation cover over a wide area. That water we can utilize for the irrigation purpose. It is available throughout the year for irrigation and other activities like drinking, bathing, washing, and cleaning too. The recharged groundwater of hilly terrains can bring dried up but rivers back to life. It prevents floods and water logging, because there is this water is under the ground, so there is water logging and flood no issue only. It does not provide breeding grounds for the mosquitoes, like stagnant water collected in ponds or artificial lakes. It is also relatively protected from contamination by human and animal mist. Our animal and we also cannot take a bath in the underground water table, so it is not possible. So these are some advantages of the groundwater. Students, Kals in Himachal Pradesh, I said you. Kals is an ancient system of canal irrigation practiced in some parts of Himachal Pradesh. This technique was developed over 400 years ago. Water from streams was diverted into the man-made channels, which took this water to numerous villages down the hillside. Management was controlled by common agreement among all the villages. That I said you. This Kals in Himachal Pradesh is really wonderful, amazing, and astonishing thing that this Kals water was reaching first to the downstream people or downstream area, not to the people who are living nearby. This is really amazing thing about this Kals in Himachal. During the planting season, water was first used. This channel made man-made channels, which took this water to the numerous village down the hillside. Management was controlled by common agreement amongst all the villages. During the planting season, water was first used by the village which was farthest. This is amazing and very wonderful thing about Kals in Himachal Pradesh, that water was first could get utilized the people who are farthest from the source of the Kal, and then by the villages progressively higher up. This was due to the fact that water first reaches farthest and then it get restricted to nearby areas. The Kals were managed by 2-3 people who were paid by the villages. In addition to irrigation, water from the Kals also percolated into the soil and fed springs at various points. But with the time, the Kals were taken over the irrigation department and most of them become non-functional, and there is no amicable sharing. Amicable means proper sharing of water and as before. Now, most of the areas in Himachal Pradesh are suffering from water scarcity due to the irregular pattern of rains and water distribution. So, don't you think, students, our ancient or our ancestor were great for in watershed management? Because see, curls in Himachal Pradesh is the ancient technique of watershed management, and which was really a successful technique. But in independent India, this still we are suffering from the problem. So I hope you understood my this thing, that our ancestors were great and had made a proper watershed management and proper harvesting techniques than today. So here are some traditional methods of harvesting could not serve needs of farmers and local inhabitants. Traditional methods of water harvesting could not serve needs of farmers and local inhabitants. Therefore, nowadays modern methods of water harvesting such as rainwater harvesting etc. are implemented, which can meet the demands of local people. Rainwater harvesting rainwater harvesting is the accumulation and storage of rainwater for reuse like drinking, domestic purpose and irrigation. Rainwater is collected through small check dams in tanks. From these dams, water is allowed to percolate in ground, thereby recharging groundwater. Since the groundwater is continuously depleting due to its overuse for domestic, commercial and agricultural purposes, so rainwater harvesting is the only tool left for recharging groundwater. So rainwater harvesting is really very great idea to follow, and everyone has to implement on it to get the water storage throughout the year, even in the non-rainy season. So some of the water harvesting methods, rainwater harvesting is the method. What other other water harvesting methods are there? Capturing runoff water from the rooftops, capturing runoff water from local catchment areas, capturing seasonal flood water from the local streams, dugging small pits and lakes, building small earthen dams, constructing dikes, building sand and limestone reservoirs. And there are some benefits of water harvesting are provides water for various purposes like drinking, cooking, cleaning, etc. Provides water for irrigation, increases groundwater resources. Thus, water harvesting is a useful and most desired method for the management of underground water. Various organizations and societies have been working to regenerate the ancient systems of water harvesting. All these efforts may restore the groundwater, which is precious water resource for all of us, and this will be used an alternative to the mega projects like dams, right? If we will use, or if you will try to practice the water harvesting techniques, then it will be a proper alternative for the mega projects, multi-crop projects like dams. So Rajendra Singh, fondly known as Water Man of India, was awarded Magsaysay Award in 2001 for his ingenious technique of rainwater harvesting. He was revived an age-old technique of collection of rainwater in earth check dams, that is Johars, to increase the water level, recharge the wells and restore greenery in Sariska forest hills in Rajasthan. So he was awarded Magsaysay in 2001. That is the name of that person, Rajendra Singh, fondly known was Water Man of India. So someone may ask you which award was given. That is Magsaysay Award in which year? 2001. For whom? Rajendra Singh. And it is called as a Water Man of India. So in which region? That is in Rajasthan, in Sariska, the greenery in Sariska and forest hills in Rajasthan. So you should know that. And can you give a list of benefits of water harvesting? Water harvesting is done for provides drinking water, then provides water for irrigation, increases groundwater resources and reduces the chances of floods and droughts.